Hey folks, welcome back. I have your latest home prices and insights for week ending August the 4th for the luxury market. Buyers, right? It's very much a buyer's market right now in the luxury space in the GTA. A quick thank you to those of you that are using the link to my calendar to book a time. You know, we set this up a few weeks ago. Basically, if you want to talk to me, anything at all related to real estate, what I've done is I've left the link to my calendar in the description. Click on that, book a time that's convenient to you. This way I know ahead of time when you want to talk, and I'll make sure my calendar is organized, my timing is organized, so I can be free when we're ready to talk about whatever's on your mind real estate wise. Thank you for those of you that have used this so far. It's very convenient. While we're here, do me a favor, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell button so you're reminded of these when these videos come up. Now today I'm talking about the luxury market in the GTA, but on other days I cover all the city of Toronto. I cover the whole GTA. I cover Peel, Durham, York region. I cover it all on different days. You'll be reminded by subscribing when these videos come up. Okay, let's get right into things. So I have here so this is just for the luxury market. If you're just joining us for the first time, welcome. But to make it on this chart, a property has to be listed or sold for minimum $3 million and up. So that's what I consider the luxury market. We have average sold price across the top here. I have eight or so months on the board, and the average sold price last week for the luxury market was sitting at $4,191,000. Now, I look at average sold price, and it's interesting to me, but I don't put too much power in what's going on with the average sold price, because this is, especially in this space, if the cutoff is you know, if you're below 3 million, you don't make it on here. The majority of properties are going to be between 3 and 5 million, and whether it goes up or down is really more indicative of those 7, 8, 9, 10 million dollar properties. But sales is something that's really, really interesting to me. So we sold only 17 luxury properties last week for week ending August the 4th. Now there was a holiday Monday in there, but you know, a lot of people still going out, going to look at properties, selling, buying through the holiday, through the long weekend. But 17 is pretty low. We were normally sitting in the 40s and 50s and 30s. 17 is really low. It's often at this time of the year, August, things kind of tend to come down. Last week of July, August are the summer months. Sales normally calm down a bit, but 17, it's pretty low. Compared to last year, well, the blue is last year's average sold price, and the burgundy is this year, and it kind of flip-flops back and forth to between this year and last year, which year had a higher average sold price. And for week ending August 4th, last year's average sold price at this time of the year was higher. Looking at the sales, we sold basically the same. We're off by one. Last year we sold 18. This year we sold 17 luxury properties. What's really interesting though is that 29% of those 17 sold at list price or more. So less than a third are selling at list price or more. So there's lots of room to take a look. Sometimes on two-thirds of the properties, you don't need to quickly get in your car, rush and go see if you're looking to buy, or if you're looking to sell, you need to be a little bit more patient. And I'll talk about days on market in a little while here. And so I've got some of the, what I found to be some of the more interesting sales, just to kind of give you a snapshot of what's happening. So here's a condo at Front and John Street, three bedroom, three bathrooms, 1900 square feet, two parking spaces, city and lake view, hot tub, outdoor kitchen. On one of the previous videos, I had this condo when it was for sale. Well, it sold. It was listed for $3,995,000, sold in 34 days for $3,995,000. So it sold exactly what it was listed at. Here's where the seller was patient. Sometimes we And even agents are guilty of this. Not every agent's the same, but agents sometimes like, gotta sell, gotta sell. You don't have to sell in right away one day. I was beating the numbers here. So here's the property. There's another photo here. There's a hot tub in the terrace there, overlooking the city and the lake. Beautiful, beautiful condo. So here's another condo, Spadina in front. It's Canada's highest and largest suspended bridge residence. So in here is where the condo is. 3 bedrooms plus a den, 4 bathrooms, 4,168 square feet. So it's bigger than most houses. 823 square foot terrace. It was listed for $4,550,000. Sold in 0 days for $4,280,000. Why do I say 0 days? When a property comes on MLS, that first day you think it's day one, it's not, it's day zero. The next day is day one. So it sold the same day it was listed on MLS for a little bit less than what they were asking for. And here's one of the photos that shows that this is that suspended bridge part overlooking the lake. Here's a beautiful home here. This is in Aurora, 9th line in Aurora Road in Stouffville. 4+3 bedrooms, 6 bath. This beautiful home sits on 2.5 acres. It was listed for $3,188,000. Sold on day one, so it's actually day two. Sold on in 1 day for $3,320,000. Sold over asking the second day that it was on the market. Stunning home. Looking at listings, we listed 43. So we're selling 17 in a week, but we're listing 43. There's 569 active luxury listings. Now, what I mean by active means that from the previous listings have not sold yet. So if you decided, I want to buy a luxury property, I want to know every luxury property that's currently for sale this moment over $3 million, there's 569 luxury properties for sale. Last week, we only sold 17. So what does that do to months of inventory? Shoots way up. We're sitting at 7.7 months of inventory because there's way more supply than demand right now. It's very much a buyer's market. Now, I've shown you some of the solds. There's exceptions where properties are selling over asking. That's because of their uniqueness, and it, unique could be the type of property. It's a combination of property, quality, style, and price. All that combined could make a property in a buyer's market sell real quick, but otherwise, buyers really kind of have some choices and have a more power now than the sellers do. Days on market is sitting at 29, so there's takes about a month to sell one of these properties right now of the ones that are selling. Let me show you some of the more interesting listings that are out there. So this is for sale. It's a Yorkville condo, 2+1 bedrooms, 3 baths, 1,880 square feet, listed for just under $3,950,000. Beautiful condo in Yorkville. Here's a property for sale. It's a modern design. We're starting to see more and more of these now. Young and York Mills area in the St. Andrew area. This is a large home. 5+1 bedrooms, 8 bathrooms. Nice lot, 76 by 150, so it's really wide. Listed for $5,400,000. Here's also St. Andrew area. This is a stunning home. 6+1 bedrooms, 13 bathrooms. It sits on 1.3 acres. 16,000 square feet finished throughout the home. State of the art, all the bells and whistles, all the toys, listed for $17,500,000. This is the front. Here's part of the back. So if you have a swimmer, they can do their swimming. If you have a soccer star, they could practice. They got a lit soccer field there. And if you don't like swimming or soccer, you could play basketball in your own indoor basketball court to get your basketball game going. That's what's going on in the luxury market. My name is Santo Sessa with Remax Premier. If I could be of any service, please reach out, use the link to my calendar in a description, and I'll give you the time that you deserve, because I'll know ahead of time when you want to talk. Have a great day.